Today I will be teaching as to how to do a multiple regression analysis. The data is already on display. Here I've got profit as a dependent variable, laborers employed, sales, years, occupation as my independent variable. In occupation I've got two groups, that is 1 and 2. 1 refers to business and 2 refers to service. With the help of value labels we can check over. Your 1 refers to business and 2 refers to service. Now we'll move on to analyze, move on to regression, from there on move on to linear, click that, and then place the profit in your dependent variable. Next, to select all the independents, with the help of shift key select all the independents and place it in the independent cell. So the method chosen, you can choose any one of the method. It is better to choose stepwise method since it will bring out only those variables which are significant. Next, move on to statistics, click R square descriptives. To check for multicollinearity, check collinearity diagnostics, and then to check autocorrelation, click Durbin-Watson. Later, click continue. Let everything be in default. Later, click OK. The results appear. Here, you have to explain your descriptive statistics for each and every variable. This is the mean value, your standard deviation. Here the n refers to the number of samples. Next, move on to correlation. Here explain all those values which are above 0.5, and the rest you can explain as either it has low positive correlation or either it has got low negative correlation, in that format. So explain only correlation below this one, below this part alone, and then move on to the next part, that is the model summary. In the model summary we have to check for adjusted R square. In most of the journals you report the adjusted R square. So here in model, in the final model, the adjusted R square is 0.819, and to check for autocorrelation we have to move on to Durbin-Watson test. Here the value should lie between 1.5 to 2.5, but however, since it is not close to zero, we can say that there is no autocorrelation. Here you can explain all the three models, but here I am going to explain only the final model. If you explain the final model, it is more than enough. However, to increase the number of pages, we can explain all the three models. Next, we are moving on towards ANOVA. In the final model, the F value is 225 and it is significant, which shows that the model is fit. Next, we are moving on to the coefficients. Before explaining the unstandardized coefficient, I will be checking over the multicollinearity. In the case of multicollinearity, we have to check the variance inflation factor, that is VIF. The VIF should be less than 10, but some studies recommend 3, some few, but however we can keep the threshold as below 10. And next we are going to explain each and every variable over here in the unstandardized coefficient part. So you have to put your constant in bracket the t value, and you have to report your sig value or p value. Here your p value is below 0.05, so it is significant at 1% level. Next, you have to explain your sales. With the increase in sales, the profit increases by rupees 0.518 and it is significant at 1% level. So you are reporting 0.518 in brackets the T value and on the top of the unstandardized coefficient, put three asterisks since it is significant at 1% level. Next, move on to occupation. In the case of occupation, you should not explain profit and occupation. Here you have to explain the occupation of the group, that is business and service as earlier stated. Now we'll move on to the data part. There you can check over in the occupation part. We have got two groups, that is 1 and 2. 1 and 2. So we are coming back to the output part. Since it is positive, it refers to that the service sector respondents earn more than business sector respondents by rupees 1320 and it is significant at 1% level. Suppose if the value is negative 1320, then you have to write it as the business sector respondents earn more than the service sector respondents with regard to 1320 rupees and it is significant at 1% level. This is how you have to explain in the case of occupation. Here, since it is positive, we say that service sector respondents earn more than the business sector respondents. The reason is for service sector, we have given a dummy value as 2. So, when it comes positive, you have to refer to those occupations where you have given a higher dummy value. Suppose it is negative, you have to refer to those occupations where you have given a lesser dummy value. Next, we'll move on to the laborers employed. With an increase in labor employed, the profit increases by rupees 634 and it is significant at 1% level. So we have to move on to the adjusted R square and explain that 82% of variation in profit is due to sales, the occupation chosen, and the laborers employed. This is how you have to explain or report in your research work. Thank you for listening.